Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever back with more LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Last time, we begun challenge mode. We accepted the challenge and completed the first four levels and Darth Maul in The Phantom Menace with getting all the blue minikits. And now we're going to finish off The Phantom Menace with Retake Theed Palace. There will be a lot in this level that we can cut out because this is the biggest level in The Phantom Menace, and these minikits are so spread out. Oh my goodness. So we definitely have our work cut out for us in this level, and I think that's how I'm going to tackle most of these, is probably doing a bunch of shorter levels, at least for the time being, and then sort of going after, let's see, I don't know, this. Going after all the blue minikits in some of these shorter levels for the time being, and then maybe tackling like a big level for next time or however it works out. Like I said, I don't have any plans to do these levels in order. If there's some levels I just feel like doing on a particular day, then, or in a particular episode, then that's how I will do them. So, you know, that's how it's gonna be. But let me switch back to the ghosts here, the ghosty boys. Let's go ahead and open up this door here. We'll go ahead and open up this door, and we have the third blue minikit over this way. Yeah. All right. Now the next one is down. Let's see where. Well, it's down in the dark side hallway. So let's it's just right down the hallway here. So I'm just gonna run down there. We don't need to make any unnecessary jump cuts straight away like this. All we gotta do is just come on around here, and we'll just need to do some triple jumping action here. Around this way. Ah, just like that. Alright. Oh, we do have to switch to a Dark Force character. I forgot about that. Switch to old Chibi here. There we go. Alright, let's go ahead and get to the next part. Nice. Alright, got another one in here. So yes, that'll put you at 5 by the time you get to the water fountain. Water fountains? They would be water fountains out here. Before you get to the fountain, and then there are two more in this part here. Let's go ahead and get the steps going here. There is one. Let's see. Let's just go ahead and pop around this way here. And push him off. Why not? He's just standing right there all by his lonesome. Oh, no, well, I guess that's what I get. Hang on. God, come on. Jeez. Let me up on this bridge! Alright. So, there's one over this way, which we'll go ahead and do like that. And then there is one... Whoa! I didn't even mean to do that as an intentional jump there. There we go. There's one over there that you can get either if you're playing as Jango or Boba. You can get it with their jets, or you can fly across as an astro droid. And there's one right here. So let's go ahead and get to the next part. Okay, and then in this little section here, we've got one down below. Right here. Alright. So let's get back up. And the next one is in the next area. So I'll see you guys there. Number 9 is all the way over here at the end of the dining room, past all that stuff where we got the power brick and the minikits, the regular minikits there, and yeah, there you go, there's number 9. And number 10 is in the hangar, so let's go ahead and get there. This one you'll actually be able to see in the little mini cutscene for this place as the game shows you all the guards that need to be freed. You'll be able to spot it right behind this group back here. There you have it. Number 10 out of 10. All right, next level. With the Phantom Menace done, we are going to go ahead and jump straight into Attack of the Clones here. I'm actually starting with Discovery on Kamino because I don't really feel like flying the speeder in Bounty Hunter Pursuit. I just get the strange feeling that it's... That level's going to be very just spread out and will require a lot of searching for them just with how complicated that kind of is. So this level, I would imagine it would be a little bit easier to find them. So because it's such a short level and there really aren't that many enemies in this level anyway until about halfway into it. So this one I'm anticipating will not take very long. Attack of the Clones has the shortest levels. You know, it's the episode that has the most short levels in the entire game. So that should not be an issue. Now I do hear one back this way. Aha, there we go. Little R2 here. Sweet. We'll take that. And look at that, I already hear another one. I love that you're able to hear them with the frickin' jingle there. There we go. Where is... Oh, it's right there. Yeah, just sitting right out in the open. Cool. All right, so we release the clones. Or not release them, but, you know, reveal them. Go ahead and wave high as Django here. Let's see. Go ahead and cut across like this. I think... Oh, it's up in there. Well, maybe something tells me there's probably one over here, too, so I'm gonna just make sure. Gotta check to make sure. Yep, had a feeling. Alright, let's go ahead and grab that one there. Jump back across, fire at that. And I can never remember... Oh, gosh, I only did this a few episodes ago, and yet I can't remember... Is it this one? Please be this one. Yes! No! It was the wrong one. How many times will it take to... Oh, wait, maybe this is it. There we go! Alright, second try, not bad at all. Okay, what's next? Alright, oh wow, there's one right back here. That was an easy find. Let's see, we'll go into Django's apartment. I would imagine there's probably some in here. Oh, well, never mind, he's just gonna run on out and not welcome us in or nothing like that. No, that would just be too much. We can't do all that. So let's go ahead and open this. There might be anything in here? No. Nothing in there. Are there any in Django's apartment here? There are not. Wow, look at that. Must be in the Kaminoan rave room here. Let's see. We got... Oh, that's right. Now they start firing at us. There we go. Where are... Well, yeah. Clone can wave high, because he's a... This is his pre-Stormtrooper days here. Oh, all right. You gotta open this one up. Okay. With that... Don't hear any others. No raving at this time. We will be heading into the next part here, so we'll just chase Django out. Don't hear any more, so let's go ahead and go through here. Got himself out, not on the platform over there. Well, I'm wondering... Ooh, you're invincible from the explosions. Nice, okay, yeah, another benefit of playing as the ghosties here. Yep. I'll just jump on up this way. We don't even need the invincibility extra on. Oh, I see. There it is. Way up there. Cool, cool. So yeah, we'll let Django go off and do his own thing. I hope there isn't one on the elevator. That's going to be... I remember that was a pain in the butt last time I did this. Let's see. I don't hear one over this way. Yeah, I don't hear one over this way, so I'm just gonna run across the bridge here and go for the other one here. The one that we've clearly seen, so yeah, let's do that. And jump on down, and yeah, we'll go ahead and... Oh, there's one up there, okay. Finally, they give you a good reason to go up there. Cross. Whoa! Sheesh, man. Didn't mean to cut him off like that, but oh well. Interrupt his flight pattern. Alright, so let's do that. Get on the elevator back up like this. And I hear one more. Chances are it's probably in that Dark Force room that you need a Sith character to open up. So let's see. Whatever's old Sheevy here. Yep. Had a feeling. Alright, well, I guess we're gonna have to switch to... I guess we're gonna have to cut these guys off. So let's go ahead and do that, shall we? Whoa! Got me. Let's save all these guys here. Oh, come on! Stupid thing. These enemies have never given me any trouble. Any other time playing this level. And now they decide to. Aha, there's our last one. Alright, next level. Gonna cut ahead a little bit, or jump ahead to Jedi Battle here, because this is another short one that we can definitely make some, you know, definitely get some good time with. So I'm just gonna do my triple jump thing. And, oh, I sailed right over it. Wow, I stink. Alright, let's go. Let's try that again, and not sail over it this time, alright. And now we'll just, oh, there's number two. This will just go around and find all the ones that are sticking out like sore thumbs here. That's such a weird saying, sticking out like a sore thumb. Like, why, I guess it's not really that weird of a saying, but I guess it's more of a funny saying than anything else. Ah, no death for a ghost. All right, let's back here. And number six. Let's see. I wonder if there's one up above right there. Might as well go ahead and check. Don't see why not here. Let's have a little look, shall we? Okay. There we go. Yeah, I still am hearing the jingle, so. Clearly there is, and we can see it plain as day right on the head. Alright, number seven. Where is number eight? It's right here. Yeah, I cannot recommend enough using the ghosts for challenge, the force ghosts for challenge mode. It just makes everything so easy, it makes it go by so quickly. Oh, now where is this tenth one? Is it back here? There it is. Wow. That was the most epic speedrun of a level in this game I have ever done. There you have it. Good to go. Da-da-da-da-da. This will give me another reason to play as Slave 1. We're going to go ahead and head into Gunship Cavalry here. This one should be also pretty straightforward. Although, you know what I've realized is that I'm not even going to be able to play as Slave 1 for very long. Because I'm probably going to need some TIE fighters or ships with tow cables to get some of these things. I'll have to switch ships anyway. Yep. There's number four back here. We can play as Darth. Yeah, this time. Number four. Yeah. Oh no. Now let's see. Play as one that. Yeah, okay. I'm trying to. Oh, get back up there. I'm trying to play as a ship that doesn't make too much noise. The speeder doesn't make that much noise. I guess the gunship doesn't really either, now that I think about it. Alright, anyway, yeah, we'll go ahead and bomb our way into the... Go ahead and bomb into the next area here. That one, watch out for ships. Now, you know what would have been really... What would have been really mean is if they made you go back and find these frickin' blue minikits and all of, like, the... original version levels too, like in the bonus room, like the original pod race, Gunship Cavalry and all those, then I think people would have hated this game for that. Anything back here? Nope. I do hear something this one. That was only number five. Whoa! Get back up there. Back there, yep. Had a feeling. So let's go ahead. Number six, since it's out in the open. clearly is behind the gate back there. And then, yeah, 9 and 10 are anticipated to be in the final area of the level. So once we grab number 7, we'll just cut ahead and, cut ahead to the last area. Bam! There we go. Okay, let's see where they are. Number 8. Just saw number 9 over here somewhere. Oh, please tell me number 10's in this area. I didn't miss it, did I? Wait, nope, I hear a jingle. It's somewhere. Where the heck is it here? There it is. Get that thing. There we go. All right. Sebulba collects number 10. All right. Off to the next level for us. We'll go ahead and round this episode off with Count Dooku. So let's go speed past our opening crawl here. Oh, not one. We don't have one to jump out into oblivion for, but we do have this one over here. So that's pretty cool. Maybe we'll play as Grievous for a little bit. These guys. Oh, they're not gonna attack me. Wow. So let's go ahead and move into here. Oh wow, it still plays the mid-level, I guess, sort of mini cutscenes of sorts, but there's that. Yeah, and all of them dead. Okay, so where were we here? I'm hearing them up here. So let's. Whoa, so close. So let's get them. Buttons. Oh, wait a second. Do I have to? Oh, there's one right there. Yeah, there we go. Anakin's helping me get up on these platforms now. Oh, wait a second. Yeah. Alright, number 5. Number. Wait, are there any this way? No. But we do have to complete this. Look at this. How fitting is this? We came here in story mode as Obi-Wan and Anakin. Oh, wow, and he actually stayed on the button this time. We came into this level in story mode as Anakin and Obi-Wan, and now we're returning after their much older and wiser Force ghosts. It's poetic in a way, wouldn't you say? Anyhow, let's get into the next section here. Yeah, Dooku should not be attacking us here because, well, for obvious reasons. But, oh yeah, look at how many of them are just displayed on screen straight away. Let's go ahead and grab them up here. Number 6, number 7. Oh, he blocked. I didn't think he was going to block. Let's see. Can I not get up there? Nope. Had to be up there, you. Oh, come on, so close. There we go. I'm just too lazy to switch characters, is really what it is. Alright. Now, I hear more. Is there one in here? No. There's one. Oh, okay. There's one on top of Dooku's solar sailor. And then I just saw the other one back here. Alright. And with that, no fighting necessary. All 10 are ours, and I think we'll go ahead and call that here. So our challenge is complete. We're the winner. And we got a whole bunch of studs, as per usual. And so with that, yeah, I think we'll go ahead and call this episode. We are slowly but surely making our way through. We've got a couple more levels in Attack of the Clones to complete. We got to do Bounty Hunter Pursuit and Droid Factory, but we'll be getting to those next time, and then we'll be getting into Revenge of the Sith. So yeah, we're coming right along with this thing. So, until next time, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll see you later.